We're going to London. We're going to London. Filling up the car, which dread to know what that's going to go to. Iris in the back. Iris, are you coming to London? Iris. Not interested one bit. Good morning. We have woken up in London. We are just on the way to a coffee shop to do a little bit of work. We had our first night here last night. We're staying in such a nice hotel, but we just didn't sleep well at all. I've got such a sore throat. It was honestly killing, but it's one of those that stops hurting during the day, which is good. So I already feel like relieved. But yeah, I was coughing all night, which obviously Dan couldn't sleep, and then he got up at 5 a.m. for his workout. So yeah, just gonna go and do some work, and then I'm gonna take you around London with me, get back into this vlogging thing that everyone does. So we are in Westfield, Stratford. It's such a big shopping centre. Until I've been to like Dubai Mall, I was like, wow, this shopping centre is insane. But having been to Dubai Mall, I'm like, just walk up them.
Yeah, I didn't know where to walk them.
Oh. Yeah, having been to Dubai Mall, I'm like, oh, it's not that big actually. But it's still big. It's very nice. Jesus. If you can hear my breathing, it's because I'm so unfit. Not been to the gym in way too long.
You're a mummy.
Because I'm a mummy. Although, it's not really an excuse. Oh, Jesus. So yeah, we are going to look for Cafe Nero and then do some work. Just come outside. This is it. Oh God, the shop of dreams. When I have my own house, it's just gonna be filled with white company. But right now we live in quite like a modern, contemporary apartment, and it's just hard to decorate with things like, I don't know, I just feel like white company is quite chic, so just doesn't go with the vibe. Got a luxury hot chocolate. Dan got his coconut latte. This is where we are. I'm just going to do some work now, and then we're going to head into central London in a bit. A little change of scenery because my laptop's died, so luckily there is a charge point. But I just thought I'd show you how I do a little bit of work in the morning. So this is a new client, I won't show you a name. But I am basically just writing her plans this morning. So, oh, you can see a name there, but not a full name, so it's fine. So I'm writing a plan. She has been dieting for a while, but she's just not pulling off the final bits of weight. So she decided to come to me for a little bit of help, and hopefully we can get her in shape in the 8-week plan that she signed up to. So this are the meals that I've done for her so far. We've got cocoa pops, granola, the frappuccino machine is in full swing over there. So eggs, yogurt, smoked salmon, just a good mix of everything, so she can kind of choose what she's feeling like the day of. A few lunch meals here. How nice does this look? So good. Also that pasta mozzarella balls, like, oh, can you just some more simple meals here. And then, well, to be fair, they're all simple actually. Snacks, so she'll have one snack a day, which can be any of these. And then I'm just in the process of writing her dinner, so I've only got four so far, guys, if you don't know, get to know, right? So most of you will know my friend Rom. She made me this curry once when I went to hers, and I was like, I need that recipe for my clients because it's so nice. It's got quite a lot of ingredients in, so it's a little bit more complex than some of them. But oh my god, it's just so good. And like, you can make it in batches and freeze it or whatever. And most of these things really are something that you've got in your cupboard. So yeah, that I highly recommend. I think it should have coriander on top, but I removed it because I don't personally like coriander, but obviously coriander has no calories, so you can add it in if you want. So yeah, I just need to write a couple of more meals for Sophie's dinners, and then we are going to move on to her workout program, cardio plan. She's actually suffering with an injury to her back at the moment, so yeah, we're not doing any weight training. We're just going to stick to cardio and diet and see how that goes. So yeah, sorry I just burped. That is just a little bit of me working this morning. So I just went to go to the toilet, and there was one in Cafe Nero, and I was like, excuse me, where's the toilet? And she was like, I don't think we have one. And I thought, surely you know if you've got a toilet where you work. And then the other guy was like, no, we don't have one. What would be funny, isn't it like a legal thing that you have to have a toilet where you're serving food and drink and there's somewhere to sit? I'm sure that's like a legal thing. But anyway, so I've come to look for a toilet. Who's like the closest one? Shake Shack, and which was next door, and I was like, 9 a.m. like Shake Shack is not open. So also, I am not looking good right now, like at all. So pale. I think this actually makes me look paler than I am. Obviously got no makeup on as well, so hopefully later I'll have a little bit of a glow up for you guys, because I don't always look this trampy. One more thing, how cozy is this from H&M? £40, and it's just like the warmest thing ever. I saw it on this girl's TikTok and I was like, I need to find that, and it was sold out everywhere, sold out online. And then we were like having a little browse yesterday in London, and I saw it and I was like, that is getting hard. So yeah, outfit of the day. So this is the jumper, this is my outfit. I am just wearing everything like oversized at the moment because obviously 17 weeks pregnant and feeling like a chunky monkey. So yeah, just thought I'd show you because this is actually so nice, I think, cozy. The awkward moment you're in toilets and cleaners come in, especially when you're vlogging, like, oh my god, died. On my way back out, Dan is working. I actually have quite a bit more work to do. It is 9 o'clock. I do have a lot of work to do, but I also just want to shop. So I might just bash out my work, and then if Dan's not finished, I'm just going to come for a browse on my own, I think. Although last time I came, right, there was so many good shops, like a big Lululemon, a massive Nike. I'm sure they had like Louis Vuitton in here as well, and like nice shops. Not that I'm going to treat myself to anything like that, but it all appears to have gone. So I'm not really sure what's going on there. That is where I found this little jacket yesterday. Yeah, if I carry on blubbing, then this vlog is going to be about 10 hours. So I'm going to love you and leave you, and I'll actually meet you in London when we go later. Me again. We are back in the hotel, and I just have to show you this because I started eating and I was like, no, I need to show how good this is. It's a cheese and ham croissant. But oh, it won't focus. Don't do that. Oh. Look at that. Massive as well. It's so good. So I'm just eating this in the hotel lobby before we go back up to Iris, because I really don't want her to beg. I don't want to share this. Dan is so good at just letting me eat everything whilst not eating at all. Hi vlog. Just come to chill, but I'm warming up because it's so cold outside. Ignore the state of our room, but it is really, really nice. That croissant was one of those things that I will think about for years. Like, guys, it was so good. I want to go back and say what cheese is in that croissant. Oh, it was just unreal. And like, the croissant was so good. It was like the size of my head as well. I tried to think about the amount of calories in it, but you're only in London once. Oh, how gorgeous is she? So the plan is we warm up, we chill for a bit, and then we're going to head into London. We're going to take Iris out for a little walk before we go. But she's had a long walk this morning, so she's supposed to be on the towel, but she's really not on the towel much. Look at this. Oh, watch your tail. See that on her leg? She always like scratches, and it's where her like back leg rubs against the floor when she's scratching. It's like taking the hair away. Aren't you gorgeous? Say hello to the vlog. Say hello to the vlog. Oh, she's so cute. I love her. Hello. What time is it, Dan? Half one.
1:30.
I did actually end up having about an hour and a half, 2 hours nap, and then we took Iris on a walk, and now we are on our way into the city. We're actually going to go to Shoreditch. A bit quirky, but it's kind of like not too near where we are, but it's nearish. So we're going to go there, and then after that we're going to see if we want to like head somewhere else, find something to do. Not really sure, but first we need to get Dan a coat because it's actually freezing, hence me wearing this massive teddy jacket still. It's Baltic, like I just saw on the news it said it was 17 degrees. It's definitely not. The wind is like ice. So we're going to go get Dan a coat and then head into Shoreditch. See where that takes us. We are in London. It's so good to be here, just to be amongst it, isn't it?
Makes you feel alive.
Makes you feel alive. We're just discussing maybe living here one day. That's it, Old Compton. Do you remember?
Yeah, oh shit, yeah.
Oh, I loved
which
it.
Means that, which means that we stayed. But it is Greek Street, right, but it's just further on.
But Greek Street was that parallel, this way.
Right, well we've stayed up here, maybe it was the other one where we stayed.
This place, in Soho.
Yeah, amazing.
So nice.
The best espresso martini.
Yes, that's what we loved. Sadly, can't enjoy that now. So Dan's not eating, I'm not drinking, but we're still making the most of it.
I am eating.
Oh yeah, he's eating. Peasant calories. But I'm making up for his lack of food.
Right, so look, that Chinese shop where we got the custard buns and whatnot, remember it? And we stayed
yes.
below.
Yeah, 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 right in the... Yeah. In the Chinatown, is it?
Yeah.
Watch out. Taxi! spotted.
There we go, that Yi Fang. Was it? That was no.
No. It was like a tiny little there, them Japanese.
Yeah, they were banging.
Can we just go and look in the window? I might not get one.
Not get.
Do you reckon?
No, I know.
I'm such a feeder. Oh my god, they've got a really full selection. Sorry, but look at all of those.
I'm 100% going for the OG.
This is the place that last time we got like Japanese pancakes, and they're like really fluffy, like this,
yeah,
light, airy. Oh, they're so good.
I can see the Wingstop sign as well.
Oh, Wingstop as well, wow. All the food is just unreal, isn't it?
There you go, you can see it on the menu. Zoom in.
Can you see that? Wow. I don't want to bore you all with like a tour of London, but we're in Chinatown now and I love it here. We literally stayed in the most random Airbnb last time, and it was like, we just walked past it actually, it was just behind some gates and like in between shops, but it was so nice inside, and we were like, what a find. We are just making our way to a little, it's like a dumpling shop, isn't it? Like a bao bun dumpling, authentic like Chinese place. And everyone is like eating them on the streets. It's called Bun House, but we've been there before and it is unreal. But look at the queue.
There's never not a queue.
There's never not a queue, to be fair. This is it. They do these amazing, I mean, everything they do is amazing. We had a huge selection last time, but they do like custard bun desserts. And they're like filled with like liquid custard. So nice.
Well, imagine a bag.
So we're gonna wait in the queue, get some, and then I'll show you. We got the goods. Look how nice the packaging is. Do you want to do the honours and open it?
I'll tell you what is better, and that is what watch you put Sophie on.
It's great. We're sat in, is this Trafalgar Square? Oh my god. So it tells you what they are.
We got two custard, one pig,
and one lamb. The custard one comes in paper because they're squirty, she said.
Yeah. My diet starts again tomorrow.
The pork one.
There's the pork?
Yeah. Nice. I'm going to try mine now. Oh, you said done. It tastes like that.
Get it in.
This is the lamb one. Wow.
Oh my god. It's so good, isn't it? So good.
So good.
Oh god. There's no pretty way of eating these things, is there?
No.
I've just realised we weren't in Trafalgar Square before. We were actually in Leicester Square. Now we're in Trafalgar Square. So I've been down for that one because he was like, oh, we'll go to Trafalgar Square and eat them. So when we sat down, I was like, oh, must be in Trafalgar Square. But I don't really know London that well. Like, I think I've been to London 3 times. Maybe 4. Not sure what that is. Oh.
There was something for the Queen, so I stopped and gave my attention, but it turns out it's just vegans.
Vegan shit.
Oi! Do you know what, as well? Everyone made a big, like, song and dance about vegan sausage rolls.
Yeah.
Terrible.
How can we talk about rule of law and not resounding?
The Greg's one.
Yeah.
No, you're not.
They're shocking. They are terrible.
I'm sorry, no, I'm not having that. The Greg's sausage rolls taste like normal sausage rolls. They're good. They're not dry, they're not like sawdust.
I tell you what, let me know in the comments. Go and try one. Then let us know in the comments.
I think he's had a bad batch, guys. I liked him. And I've had them many a time. And if there isn't a meat one, I'm just like, well, it's fine.
Would you like to go and see Big Ben, or would you like to go to Covent Garden?
Covent Garden.
What Big Ben's that?
Big Ben is there in the distance. Anyway, I'm gonna go and enjoy a little walk with Don. We have just stopped off at the Ivy for a little drink. It's so cute in here. We're just in Covent Garden, but yeah, just having a little drink. And it is looking cute. Oh my God, what a long day. We have done about 30,000 steps. Well, I say we. Dan's done about 30,000. I've done about 21,000 because he went to the gym this morning and did a crazy long run. So we got back from central London about half an hour ago. I took Iris to the gym. I took Iris for a walk and Dan has gone to the gym. He's having his first off-plan meal tonight. I don't know if anyone knows, but he is doing like a cut for a fight, like a fight camp cut boxing kind of thing. He doesn't actually have a fight plan, but he has like got really into his boxing. He used to do it when he was a bit younger, and he used to do MMA fighting as well. But he's just loving that at the moment, and he wants to do, well, I think he wants to go pro, but he's got to do a few amateurs first or something. So he's just kind of like gauging the weight that he thinks that he wants to fight at. He's weight making, well, trying to make weight for a 175 pounds fighter, which is, I think, God, I've heard him say it so many times, but there's that many different weights of fighters, like super middleweight, I think. That could be totally wrong. Basically, he just needs to be at 175 to fight at that weight. Now, Dan is 6'2", and I actually think he's taller than that. Like, everyone says, everyone that meets him always says how tall he is. So that's like low for his height, and he is already so lean, like shredded to the point where he's got like veins running through his ribs, his stomach, like a proper 8-pack of abs. Yeah, he is just lean. You will have probably seen on my Instagram if you follow me on there. Anyway, so he is currently sitting at 185, I think, 185 pounds. Oh my God, I've just got to show you this. You okay? Gonna come up, come on then. Good girl. Hello. Hello. Oh, that's really nice. Yeah, so Dan's been doing that for, I think, 4 weeks today. He's lost a ridiculous amount of weight. I think he's lost 23 pounds in something like 30 days, which is excessive. He's been on peasants calories of like 1300 for the past couple of weeks, and exercising 2 or 3 times a day. Sorry if I'm rambling, but my whole point is tonight is his first off-plan meal, so we want to get it right, but we're also absolutely shattered and can't be bothered like going back into the city. So we've got an Italian booked, which we could go to. It's only like a 10-minute walk, and that's been recommended to us, so it might be quite nice, called Figo, I think, or even get like a delivery. I'll literally see what he feels like. Sorry, but she is just a queen. She loves being here. She absolutely loves it. Like, I took her on a walk and she pulled me back in the hotel when we got back, like straight to the lift, got in the lift, ran down the corridor to our door, like stood outside, like nudging the door to get in. She's just in her element. She, anywhere we go, she goes now. Like, she is just a princess. Yeah, so I'm gonna have a little look at other places we can maybe go, and then when Dan's back, give him the options. By the way, I'm getting full of a cold and I don't know where it's come from, like my nose is streaming. And last night, I think I said, but I slept so bad because my throat was just in complete agony. So I'm hoping I have a better sleep tonight. And I felt so bad for Dan because obviously he's dieting, like he's doing a hell of a lot of exercise, and I was just up all night like coughing, so he couldn't sleep whatsoever, and I just felt so guilty. And then he was up at 5 a.m. for his first gym session this morning, so he was like, I think it said on his watch he'd slept like 3 hours 10 minutes, which is really, really not good. I've actually had a nap today, as you know. Had one earlier when we got back from doing our work in the coffee shop, and while Dan was on his other gym session, I think he was, or he was doing work or something. Who's a needy girl? Ooh. Let's wipe that snot out your eyes. So yeah, anyway, we'll decide where we go. I will show you what we get and then call it a night for today. But I've actually really enjoyed vlogging. I feel like I need to get back into the swing of things. Like, I don't think it comes naturally at the moment, but yeah, just getting back online, aren't I, Iris? Doing what I love. Wow, my nose actually streaming. Can you see that? That's so bad. Yeah, I feel like with YouTube, with Instagram, you wouldn't post a photo without thinking like, oh, I feel like I look good in that. Whereas like YouTube, you're literally filming whether you've got no makeup, makeup, getting blown away in the wind. And yeah, I just think it's more raw and real. And I just have less anxiety about posting, to be honest. Like, on YouTube, I honestly couldn't care if I get one view, like, and that'll probably be done. Whereas, like, Instagram, I feel like I'm always checking my insights, which are shit at the moment, and thinking, like, oh, like, my business is going to go to shit. No one sees my posts. There is a lot of pressure behind it. Like, obviously, my business pays for my uni, it pays for my lifestyle, pays for all the outgoings I've got, like, my car. So there is times when I put pressure on myself to, like, and I really stress and resent posting, whereas I'm just doing YouTube for fun, like to have a chat and just as like a release. So I don't know how often I'm going to post. If I get into it, probably the more often, but right now, yeah, I'm just going to put London weekend on and see how it gets on. And then if I'm doing anything interesting after that, just vlog it and like keep you guys up to date with what's going on with me, basically. Gonna stop rambling now, but yeah, that was a long chat. 9 minutes. This is where we are going tonight. Dan decided that he had the energy to come and venture out. I mean, it was literally a 5 minute walk, so how nice does that look? Oh, can't wait, it's Italian. I will show you the food when we get it. It's so loud in here, but these are just the starters. We've got truffle arancini and then cheesy garlic bread. And Dan is just writing a little caption. Look how nice it is in here though. I'm going to go to the hospital. good did that look?
We should have told them that we were sharing.
We finished the meal. It was so nice, but it was a hell of a lot of carbs and cheese. Like, I was just dipping my chips in tomato ketchup by the end, just hoping for some like ketchup-y, tomato-y vegginess, which is not like me, but it was like overwhelmingly cheesy. And now I'm so full. My jeans, oh my god, if you could see how tight they are, you would be giving me a round of applause.
Reese's shape.
Fuck. I'm so full, and Dan's bringing me around the food court. Showing me. I bet that is good. You know? I bet that is good. When we were in London, when we went to the centre, we picked up 7 cookies, which we've already started to demolish, but I just wanted to show you. Oh, yeah. And then there's some under there. And then, Dan, show me the shake. We did end up getting a 5 Guys shake with banana Reese's.
Mm-hmm.
Iris wants to get involved. Iris. Right, so yeah, that is the end of our day. We're gonna smash these and go to bed. So I'm calling it a night here.
Try it.
No thanks, I don't want to take my cloth. Yeah, so good night. Morning. We have done. Do you know what you want? Oh yeah. Oh my god. This is what I came for. That right there. Oh wow. Anything else? And
Get one each,
girl. Yeah. Cinnamon Social. Can you do some work? In a really nice area. Whereabouts are we, Dan? Near Oxford Street.
Yeah, it's off Oxford
Street. It's so nice, but yeah, I'm going to show you all of these amazing toasties. Oh wow, look at them. And do ya? Truffled mushroom, tuna melt, ham and cheese. Wow. Ham time. We're gonna go back to the hotel, get Iris, pack the car, and then take on a little walk before we head back home on a 5-hour drive. But we have had the best time, so I'm so grateful for just being here, even if it's just for a couple of days. We are all checked out the hotel and just walking around the Olympic Park before we leave to head back home. So we've had a great time, haven't we, Bob?
We have indeed.
Watch my camera, you're on my camera. Iris. Hello, Daddy. It's been so cold, I've actually got my winter coat out and not got one regret, but this is apparently like such a big park. I think it's like 13 acres, but we've not really found much grass yet, have we? So this is the last thing we're doing in London. We're gonna
get tickets for the West Ham game, shall we?
No, we're not going to the West Ham game. We're right by the West Ham stadium, and there's a game on now. But yeah, we are gonna go on a walk around here. Gonna head to get some snacks for the road. There's like this really nice, oh, I showed you actually on my vlog yesterday, I got a ham and cheese croissant. I've gotta get it again because it's honestly one of those things that I will think about for years. And if I don't have it again, I'll just regret it. So yeah, going to go and get that after and then get in the car and go. My dad's run on ahead, so I'm going to love you and leave you. But that is pretty much the end of the London vlog, I think. Thank you guys for tuning in and watching, and hopefully I'll keep this up and carry on vlogging. I am actually starting to get a bump now, off topic, but hopefully do like a few more little pregnancy bits and things like that. So yeah, lots of love.
You are having a baby boy.
Yeah, that's amazing. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
He looks